Hello everybody and welcome back. We're going to continue into the game here, Euro Truck Simulator 2 of course. We're up in Aberdeen. We arrived there last night, I think, or well, I'd say last night. It was last night when I was actually playing the game. We arrived up there, up into the freight market here. We spent a bit of money. Oh yeah, we earned some money and then we went ahead, we bought a new truck. And we spent a bit of money by sorting out that truck and hiring another driver for our garage in Plymouth in the south of England. Show Mr. Bond. It looks like we're down to $9,000, which is a fairly low amount of money. I think I need to put some fuel in as well. Looking at the jobs, there's Aberdeen to Gdansk, which is a tank, and I like it, so we'll take it. It is an urgent delivery, it looks like. I do have an ADR Class 8, and it pays 103,000. So we will set the GPS for that, and we will hop into the truck wherever I am. And I may actually be here already. Yeah, that'd be kind of cool. It would be kind of cool. Somehow they've managed to get the trailer that I dropped behind my truck out from behind my truck without moving my truck. I don't know how they do that, but they're able to do that. I reckon it's one of those, don't you? It'll be handy if it is. It means we don't have to go driving around Aberdeen very much. So let's check it out here and... Yep, that bees her, so we'll take that job. And then we'll stick her in reverse, and we'll head back. I can just about see the icon in the mirror there. So, back on the mirrors. Now, when they bring out the trailers, whenever that arrives, sometime next year, I would assume, I'm going to have to start working even more on my reversing skills, which are improving, but far from anything professional. Not too bad here though, we're coming in at a slight angle off, but we will be able to make that connection, I hope. I would like to have realistic hitching up, I really would. I'd like to have a sound of the fifth gear rubbing in, and I'd like to have a clunk sound when the fifth gear is loaded up, and I would like trailers to be slightly pushed around when you're off center and you have yourself a bad approach. That would be kind of cool, and I think there's a lot of folks who would probably put their thumb up and say, yeah, I'd like that too. You can always have that option of, you know, just you know, skipping that part and just auto-connecting. There's plenty of folks who want that because that's the way they want to play, and, you know, I'm all for that as well. Just I wouldn't choose it if the option was there. Personally, myself, I like the challenge. Right, well, we're on the road. Now, before we go much further, we have 3 hours and 52 minutes of driving, so this might be a bit of a short one. We have 2,085 miles to go, and we have half a tank fuel, so we're not too bad, really, as it goes. Come on, Mini, where are you going? You don't know where you're going. Now this car is underneath me, and he's going to cut across me. Jesus, you do have to give him a bit of room, don't you? But we're good, we're on the road, we're good, we're going powerful now. A few lights might help. Oh, they're on. Right, so we're out of Aberdeen and we're heading down towards Newquay upon Tyne again. Slap a few brakes on here now and bring her to a stop. And then we're heading over to Gdansk in Poland, I think, isn't it? Yeah. To WGCC. We have 78 hours to do 41 hours of driving, it seems. So that gives us a couple of rest periods. Now, is there any chance of me making Newcastle upon Tyne in 3 hours from Newquay? There isn't, because it's a 6-hour journey. based on yesterday's experience, probably a little over 6 hours actually. So, yeah, well, we're not going to be able to do that, basically. Now that's a 30, which means I can probably get away with doing a 50 through here. And we're not really doing 50. I do have the old beacon on as well, don't I? I don't know if I need that beacon now. I'm just pulling a tank. I don't want to turn that off. Although it is ADR 8, and I don't know the rules for when you have the beacon on or not. Must go and look those up. I keep saying that and I keep not doing it. Throw the Indicator on here now anyway and see if we can hit heavy on the brake. Heading back down towards Edinburgh in Glasgow. Sorry about that. Using up a bit more of the road than I needed there. That wasn't the most excellent execution of a turn. But sure, anyway, there's plenty of not so much excellence, I mean, in this career, is there? Yeah. Fuel-wise, I have 9 grand in the pocket, and I don't really need to buy fuel just yet. So I think I'll not buy any fuel, and hope that some of the drivers that I have will deliver a bit of money into the old account, start padding that out a little bit more. Because I do need money for the crossing, which will be over a grand. And I will be putting fuel to the tune of maybe 1500 or 1600 euro into the tank when I fill next. So all in all, I'm not doing too bad. With 9 grand, I'll be able to kind of keep myself going for a while. I'll be able to get this load delivered, and this will earn 103,000. Madness, isn't it? Mad money. The economy, I haven't looked really at mods. I know that there's 1.13 update, which is imminent by all accounts. We're the 12th of September 2014 in the real world here, and I think that was delayed for a little while, I don't know how long, because of the quality testing that they're doing. So that'll be out probably in a couple of weeks at least, and you know, that would reset me back to no mods, of which I'm running no mods now at all, and I haven't been running any mods for quite a while. It's been stock game for quite a while now, and I'm kind of, you know, the only mod that I'd possibly be interested in reintroducing is the economy mod. But I'm kind of getting, yeah, I'm not even convinced about that. I like the idea of the economy mod, but I am progressing up through the game and, you know, buying new trucks and all the rest fairly aggressively because of how the game is designed and with the slightly inflated job prices that are available. 103,000 to drive to Poland with a tank of fuel is fairly rich in any world. It does enable me to build up my empire that little bit faster, which, you know, is fairly okay. No problem with that. If I'm going with a hard economy mod, something that's a bit more realistic, then I'd be doing a hell of a lot of driving in order to earn the 103,000 that I will earn for this job. I might have to do upwards of 7 jobs to earn the equivalent amount, which would slow down progress significantly. My question to myself is, does that improve my sense of achievement? And I have run the hard economy mod previously, and from a driving perspective, it means I get to drive more in order to earn the same amount of thing, and it has a fairly significant impact on the speed at which I can afford to buy different trucks. But now that I have got myself to a third garage, I've hired you know, a full complement of drivers in two garages, and I'm 3 out of 5 in the Plymouth garage. Maybe it is time to start reverting back to the hard economy, because, you know, it's more realistic, really. And I quite like that in my head. The hard economy will affect my AI drivers as well, because their job prices will correspondingly be made more realistic. But having more drivers working does compensate a little bit for the speed at which I'm earning money. So in those regards, I think there's a lot to be said for it. Now, looking at the end of the last video, we looked down through the earnings of each of my hires, and you know, they're in the single digit of thousands, and maybe a couple of 10 and 12,000 jobs. None of them are in the 100,000 region, or 115, or 117, or 113 that I've been earning. So they are kind of 10% of, or less, the value of their jobs. That didn't even make sense, that last sentence. The value of their jobs are about 10% of the value of my jobs. So maybe if I turn the hard economy on, their job prices won't change that much, and mine will just reduce that 90% and become priced in line with the AI's. That would be acceptable, and I think that would possibly be a little bit more realistic. Let's see what happens. I don't know, because the last time I ran the hard economy mod, I don't believe I had any AI drivers working for me. Maybe one. No, I don't think I had any at all. I hadn't even... No, I must have had a couple, actually. Hang on. In my original V&A garage, I probably did have some AI drivers. Huh, I'll have to go back and see that video. See what the story was there. But anyway, that's the thoughts at the moment. I think that's kind of a direction that I am leaning towards. Not that you can have everything at once, but I want everything at once. And SES could go and work in a hard economy option into their configuration of the player's game. Just a little radio box that would reset the numbers. Immediately, that doesn't sound too hard to do. And I would really appreciate if they would do it. But there's no real sign of that happening. So that means relying on an excellent mod download that would effectively redo those numbers. It would be better to have that as an option in the game, because it would mean that it would be persistent when updates occur and new versions of the game are released. I wouldn't have that mod conflict that would occur very often, or at least the risk of it occurring. Actually, with the hard economy mods and some of the mods, they don't seem to be too negatively affected by version changes. The version change problems occur when you have trucks or other type of updates. I don't think that, like, for instance, the hard economy mod is completely independent of updates, so it depends on what the update is about. And maybe one of the updates that I was referring to didn't really have any effect on that area of the game, so the hard economy mod continued to work. But in later updates, where there would be changes to other components of the game, the hard economy mod would cause a crash. Not becoming somebody who's against mods, but I haven't been using them, and I'm quite okay about not using them for quite a while now. But you know, there is kind of work to do for SES in that area, and I think there's quite a few of us who, frankly speaking, would look out for that kind of an update and appreciate it a lot. I guess from SES perspective, there's 101 good ideas and 1,000 more behind them. And they've got to work out what are they going to do. So the fact of the matter is, they are doing stuff, and they're working quite hard to get a load of stuff sorted out. So Maybe they'll get to it. Right, well, we're back into a little bit of rain here, which is interesting because I don't recall there being so much rain in the previous long time, actually. And we had rain in the last session, and now it's raining again. We are in Scotland, of course, so it could be in keeping with the weather profile here. I wonder if there is some randomization based on country on the likelihood of driving in the rain. I don't know, I suppose. I don't know. Kind of wondering out loud if that's too much to expect, but there's lots of little surprises that that the game throws up every so often, and this might be something behind the scenes. A little tweak that they've done. Right, well, now we are beginning to get tired, as you've heard. I haven't yawned myself yet, which is unique. We will be drawing this video to a close, I think, fairly soon. But what we will do is we will go through the situation with our drivers and see what's happening. Services are close. Might be going a little too fast here. What's my speed? I'm doing 70. I need to slow down a little bit more. The camera is just up here. It is a 50. But a 50 allows me to do 80 in this country, so switching between kilometers per hour and miles per hour. As we go across the bridge. And the G25 rumble is letting me know that we're passing over sections of the bridge that are not in line with each other. There's the camera. We're doing a healthy 80 and yeah, we're safe enough. That'll do. 60 is now allowed, which is we shouldn't be too far away now from the services. Services? Getting out to the services? My brutal Scouse accent. 200 YDS. And we shall pull her in here. Stick on the indicator. And we'll roll her over to the left. Cutting the corner off that line. And I think we've possibly been in here before. We have. We haven't been in on the other side. We have been in on this side previously. I'm getting tired and I should find a place to park. Yes, go away, pop-up. And stay away, for God's sakes. Right, we need to find a place to park. There's not an awful lot of space here, but we will get it in on this side. And then bring it around fairly handy. That's a trailer that looks like it's sitting up there. Alrighty then. There we go. Put on the handbrake, turn off the engine, turn off that, turn off some lights, pop out in the rain and have a look and see how close we are to the truck in front. We're good, we're grand, we're lovely. And we need to sleep, so we are going to sleep. Right. That is actually going to draw an end to this short video. It gets us back out on the road and we are done. We're done for the day. We are at the top of the cab here. It's quite nice up there, I suppose. Storage space. Often wonder about, you know, there's a second bunk just above, and that's in that position there. The lower bunk is there, and then you have the storage space up there. I often wonder. I guess that's for a TV, would it be? Flat screen would fit it on there. I often wonder what I would do if I was in a truck like this and where I'd put stuff and how I'd fare out with setting up whatever few little things I have. Okay. Until the next time, go handy. Oh, before we go, I did want to have a quick look at the company situation and look at the driver situation. And Orsola is our new latest hire. She's driving a man. And what struck me yesterday was I didn't have any other man trucks that I had bought. So we're buying another couple of man trucks to fill out Plymouth in at least one of the next two slots in that garage. The average kind of profit per day for these guys is that. But if I was to go to, let's see, who's a fairly good performer? Lenka is not bad. And we show her logs. They're, you know, 9, 4, 6, 12. You know, the 12 is the biggest. Let's see what Lucy has been doing. Again, similar job prices. Bela is on the lower job prices, but Bela is a lower level. Let's go to the Gertrude is 5. And again, aside from that problem one in Swansea, they're all single digit thousands. We look at Senka, let's look at Sabrina. Again, yeah, they're all kind of sub 10,000, maybe the odd 10 or 11,000 job. They're 4.2, so they're lower. Lucy I've already looked at. Whereas me, myself, I can't see my log, which is a pity. You know, why, what's going on? So, hard economy, I must go back and check and see what they do. Alright, that'll do. Until the next time, go handy. Thanks a million for watching.